Hello everyone, I'm Corey Tafoy, the District 50 Superintendent, and I want to share with you a little bit more explanation on an email that you received last Friday. The email that you received asked you a question that may seem very simple to us inside the district, but may be a little bit more complicated for you to answer, so we want to provide a little bit more detail on the differences between remote and hybrid learning, the two options that you have on this survey. So the important thing for you to understand is this is a really optimistic approach from the district. We're hoping, fingers crossed, that in the second semester we can be back and offer our families a hybrid option. So let me explain to you the difference between the two options you have. The first one is very easy to explain, and that's the remote learning option. That would be no change to what we're currently doing right now. 5 days a week, remote learning, where that time schedule is like 9 o'clock till 2 o'clock. So nothing would really look that different. But what is different is you could choose also the hybrid option. So the hybrid option offers 2 days a week in person. The other 3 days you would still be remote. On Monday and Tuesday, your child may come in, or if you're on the other side of the geographical boundary, you might be in on Thursday and Friday. So you would be in 2 days and then you'd be remote 3 days, because Wednesday will still be that day of deep cleaning within the buildings. So you have that option to choose. The day would be more similar in hours to what our conventional school year is, from 8 till 2:45. So you'd have a little bit more time in person with our classes. Now, this is going to be a little bit tricky, because whatever option you choose, we're likely to see some changes in your teachers that your child may have, or your class schedule may have. Because remember, we're trying to group all of the remote students into one class and all the hybrid students into one class, so that if we're switching back and forth, for example, if we can't start hybrid right away in January, maybe we can get to it in March. We want to make sure that all the students are still grouped together. So that's one thing that's important for you to know. The decision on which choice you'd like for your child, and we need you to do the survey for each child you have, would be by November 16th, because that's going to allow our principals time to adjust class rosters and schedules, figure out what classes can run, and if there's any classes that can't run. It'll give the principals enough time to really explain and work out all the details for all of our families. We're hoping, again, like I said, to do this starting in January. We probably would start sometime in the middle of January. So there's a lot of details we'll still share with you, but we do want to give you a chance to understand your two options for your child, so you can make the best decision for them. So if you have any other questions about this, feel free to reach out to your building principal, who can explain all these options and how it would play out at your child's school, or reach me here at the district office. Thank you very much.